everyone, this is Sir Manoj. Welcome to computer class. Today we'll discuss about wrapper class methods, how to convert string to primitive type. Let's begin the class. So methods of wrapper class. So here we'll discuss conversion from string to primitive type. So how to convert string to integer type, string to long type, string to float type and string to double type. So this int, long, float, double are primitive types we have to convert. Well, what is string? So a set of character enclosed within double quotes is known as a string. For example, Java within double quotes, Paytm 220 within double quotes, Lenovo within double quote, 2002 within double quote. So these all are the examples of string. So you have to remember, the conversion from string to primitive type data is possible when it contains only numbers. Understand, you cannot convert string that which contains character to primitive type. The conversion from string to primitive type is possible when it contains only numbers. And if you will try to convert this Java to primitive type, then you will get an error. Understand? We'll discuss conversion from string to primitive type. For this, two methods are used. Number one is parse ints, another one is value of. The syntax is integer variable equals to integer dot parse int within string, and number two, integer variable equals to integer dot value of string. Either you can use parse int method or value of method. See the example, int x comma k equals to 15. So both x and k are integer type, then string r equals to 35. Now you can see 35 is a string, so I want to convert that to integer type. So this is the method, x equals to integer dot parse int r, or you can use x equals to integer dot value of r. So your integer is the wrapper class. So the variable x results in 35 without quotes. See the example, system.out.println k plus x. So see, k is integer type and x is integer type. So the value of k is 15, but what is the value of x? The value of x is 35, because we have converted that r and it will store in x. So the output will get 50. Now see the another example, system.out.println k plus r. So k is integer and r is string. So I told you, if you will add integer plus string, you will get string. So here the output is 1535. It will concat. K value is 15 and r value is 35. Understand the first method, how to convert string to integer type? Okay. Next we will discuss how to convert string to long type data. Here also same thing, two methods use. You can use either parse long or value of. The syntax is given, long variable equals to long dot parse long within bracket string, and second one, long variable equals to long dot value of. So you can use parse long or value of, any one, not both the methods. So the example, long x and k equals to 1505, string r equals to 3055. Now we have to convert this r to long. So see the example, x equals to long dot parse long r, or x equals to long dot value of r. So the variable x results in 3055 without quotes. Okay, now see system.out.println k plus x. So you have to find out the data type of k and x. So k is long and x also long, so long plus long you will get integer value. If it is the system.out.println k plus r, then concatenation. So the output you will get in string format. Understand? So this is the method to convert string to long. Next we'll discuss how to convert string to float type data. See, here also same thing, parse float or value of. Syntax, float variable equals to float dot parse float within bracket string, or float variable equals to float dot value of string. Example, float x comma k equals to 15.2f. f is the default value of float. String r equals to 30.25. Example, x equals to float dot pairs float r. So the r string will convert to float. So the value x results in 30.25 without quotes. Look at the example. System.out.println k plus x. So here k and x both are float. So you simply you can add and the answer you will get in a floating value, that is 45.45. If you type system.out.println k plus r, so you will get the output in a string format. So k is float and r is string. So if you will add anything with string, it will convert to string. Understand? Next, we'll discuss string to double type data. Here also same thing, parse double or value of. Syntax, double variable equals to double dot parse double string, or double variable equals to double dot value of string. Example, double x comma k equals to 15.20, string r equals to 3.25. Here we will convert r to double. So how will you do? X equals to double dot parse double r, or x equals to double dot value of r. So the variable x results in 3.25 without quotes. If you type system.out.println k plus x, so you will get 18.45 because both are double type value. And if you type system.out.println k plus r, so here k is double and r is string, as usually you will get the output as a string format. Anything if you add with string, you will get string. Okay, so we came to know that how to convert string to primitive with the help of the wrapper methods. Understand?
एक गांव में दर्जी रहता था। उसकी दुकान पर रोज एक हाथी आता था। दर्जी उसे केला खिलाता था। हाथी दर्जी को गांव की सैर कराता था। एक दिन दर्जी शहर गया। दर्जी ने अपने लड़के से कहा कि दुकान आज संभालना। लड़का दुकान पर पहुंचा तो रोजाना की तरह हाथी आया। लड़के को शरारत सूझी, उसने हाथी की सूंड में सुई चुभो दी। हाथी तालाब के पास गया, वापस लौट के आया। लड़के को लगा कि अब की बार और जोर से सुई चुभूंगा। उससे पहले ही हाथी ने अपनी सूंड में भरा गंदा पानी दर्जी की दुकान पर फेंक दिया। दर्जी के सारे कपड़े गंदे हो गए। लड़के को समझ आ गया कि जानवरों के साथ ऐसा व्यवहार नहीं करना चाहिए। काश उस हाथी की तरह ही वो हथनी जो केरला में निशब्द ही इस दुनिया को छोड़कर चली गई और उसके पेट में पल रहा एक नन्हा हाथी भी उसके साथ चला गया। काश वो भी हम इंसानों को कुछ सिखा पाती।